Well, welcome back again. Today we're going to talk about the convection feature of the sharp oven. And the convection feature is just like your regular oven, and so you're going to bake in it just the same way that you do in a regular oven. If you remember in the RVs, they have the microwave convection oven, and most of the time there's no regular oven. And so that then when you're out on the road, when you want to do your baking, then you will just bake in your oven that you otherwise use for your microwave oven. So what we're going to do to start with, I'm going to be doing some cookies in just a little bit, and I need the oven to have a chance to preheat. So I'm going to just turn on preheat. So I look at the directions to see the time that it, temperature that it takes. And so we're going to preheat the oven. So I'm going to push preheat, and then I push number 6 for 350, and then I push start. And when I do that, then the oven will start preheating on it. At 110, the oven isn't going to be as fast as an oven, a convection oven that's part of your range. So in general, in the ovens that are in the RVs and the ones that are installed like this, you're going to find that the convection feature is very similar to your regular oven. So I tend to use the same temperature and the same time as my regular recipes. There are a few ovens where things tend to brown a little too fast on the top. And in those brands, they usually recommend going down 25 degrees, but when they go down 25 degrees, they need to extend the time. So with the cookies today, I set the oven at 350, and during the preheat time, if I push convection, it's going to tell me what the internal temperature is. So right now, the temperature is 300 degrees. And one of the ways that I can still, you know, get maximum amounts of cookies in there is to do two layers, and so I'm going to do one layer on the turntable here, and I'm going to use these Teflon coated baking rounds, and this is a Teflon coated fiberglass, and I found this at the houseware show a few years ago, and I had it cut in rounds that fit on the turntable and on the rack, and I'm going to just put that on the rack, and I don't want this to slide around, so I'm going to just put a silicone hot pad underneath it so that that's not going to slide around with the cookies on it. So I'm going to open the package of cookies. These are just the regular refrigerated. These are the big deluxe cookies. You can hear the oven now. That means that it's preheated. And so I'm going to just place half of the cookies on the bottom layer and half on the top. And I intentionally left the turntable out because I wanted to have a chance to get the cookies all ready while the oven was preheating. So I have 6 on the bottom and 6 on the top, and so then I'm going to just stack these two in the oven. I can stack them and then put them in the oven, or a lot of times it's just easier to first put in the turntable and then to put in the rack. So the oven is hot, and so I can just open the oven door, place the turntable in, and then place the rack with the cookies on it in, and then I'm going to set the oven. So I'm going to set convection, 350, and then 1400 for 14 minutes, and then press start. While the cookies are baking, we'll just talk a little bit about preheating and how the power will vary as you're out on the road and you're in different RV parks. You're going to find some RV parks, you'll have really good amperage, and so your oven is going to preheat very quickly, similar to what mine preheated here in my home. Usually it should preheat in like 10 to 15 minutes when you have good amperage. But a lot of times in parks, if other people are using their air conditioners or other electrical equipment, or if you're in a park that's a little older and so the wiring isn't quite as heavy as in the newer parks, you're going to find that you will have less amperage. And when you have less amperage, your preheat times are going to be longer. Just remember that when you are preheating, you can check, push the convection button, and then that will show you what the current temperature is, so you know how close you are to the temperature you want to get. And with a lot of your foods, you'll just find that baked things will turn out better if you preheat the oven. So like the cookies, the muffins, the kinds of things that we preheated in the past will be good to continue to preheat. And then you're going to get the nice rounded tops. You can certainly bake things without preheating, but you're going to find that you're going to have to add time on to allow the oven to get hot. And the product is going to tend to be flatter, and the cookies are going to spread out more. So while our cookies are baking, I'm going to get some biscuits ready. And with the cookies, we did the two layers. I'm going to do biscuits next. So then I'm going to use the short rack. So use the short rack for one level and use the high rack for two levels of cooking. I just opened the biscuits here, the refrigerated biscuits. And so I'll just put these onto the baking sheet. put them around here, and if I'm, these are the big ones, so they're going to be, I have to put them to, just a little bit together to get them to all fit on.
Okay, as our cookies get closer to getting done, I want to just open the oven door and just check them, and you can see they're browning nicely, so I think our timing will be perfect on it. If the timing looks like it's going to take a little bit longer, remember that I could push minute plus, and every time I push it, I'll get an extra minute in whatever program I'm in. So when I'm in the convection feature, if I push minute plus, then I will get, you know, an extra minute of straight convection time. So it'll still be convection at the temperature that I have the cookies in for. When I take the cookies out, I'm going to immediately set the oven again for 350 degrees. I'm going to put it on preheat, and that way the oven will stay hot. And that's if you're going to do baking where you bake one thing after another, that's a good way to keep your oven from cooling down in between things. So I'm going to lift off the upper layer of cookies and then pull out the turntable and set it on. I have a silicone lid here that's also a trivet, so I'll just set it down there for just a minute. I'm going to close the oven door and then push preheat and 350 and start, so that the oven will stay hot so that I can get the biscuits in then in just a little bit. So I'm going to just, the cookies, I'll just show you how they look. And you can see the ones on the turntable will brown just a little bit faster than the others because the turntable will hold the heat on it. And so I'm going to set these over to the side and let them cool. And then I want to use the turntable again. And so I'm going to just slide that off onto it. And then I'm going to check the temperature and just see how my oven is. It's at 335, so we'll just let it continue to. The oven is hot now, so what I'm going to do is to just put the turntable back in, and I'll just go ahead and put the biscuits on the turntable before I put it in, and then just open the oven door, put it in, and the package directions say to bake it at 350 for 13 to 17 minutes. So I push convection. And then number 6 for 350, and then I'll go 1300 for 13 minutes and press start. And I always try to keep the turntable on. You certainly can turn it off, and you can bake a 13x9 cake, or you can put in, instead of using the two layers with the racks, you could put in a cookie sheet, a small cookie sheet in there, turn it off. But when you turn off the turntable, then you are going to have to rotate the food about 180 degrees, about a third of the way through the cooking time. So with the silicone dishes, remember when you're baking, you can use everything you've used in the regular oven. So you can use your metal, your glass, and the silicone, and some of your high heat plastics. But when I do use the silicone, I even trim the corners of my pans just so that they will rotate in there, because I'm going to get better cooking than if I turn the turntable off. Once the cookies have cooled a little bit, then we're ready to take them off of the sheet. And if they're still warm, you can use a spatula. A lot of times when they're cold, they'll just slide off, and then just put them onto a cooling rack. So we'll just slide these off real quickly. And then you just wash up your baking rounds and dry them off, then roll them up and put them into a paper towel tube for storage. And then with your, in your galley kitchens, you don't have a lot of space, so this will just tuck down in next to your silverware or in a cupboard in a little crack, and is an easy way to store it. Or you can also just leave them in, and it'll help to keep the turntable clean. And I wanted to show you how that the cookies, they're still a little fragile, but they brown nicely on both sides, so they're just as brown on the bottom as they are on the top. And this is not necessarily true in all brands of ovens, and that's one of the reasons why I like the Sharp oven so well, is because the air does circulate, and so that I really get nicely browned foods all the way around. Okay, our biscuits are completed now, so we'll just open the oven door, and it looks like they're finished, they're cooked. So just take a hold of them, and you can see that they're, you have brown on the top, and they're brown on the bottom. So you've had a chance today to see how the oven bakes, and how well it bakes, and how much it's like your regular oven. So don't be afraid of it, but just try some of the baking, and just use the same times and the same temperatures that you used with your regular recipes, and see the good results that you get. Now the next video is going to be on the combination setting, where I combine a little microwave with the convection, and then we'll be able to cut our cooking times in half. So I look forward to having you join me then. And meanwhile, happy convection cooking.